will start with arterial blood pressure monitoring. It is the most commonly used part of hemodynamic monitoring. Practically 90% of the times when we are doing the hemodynamic monitoring, we use the direct arterial pressure monitoring. The basic advantage being it gives us the beat-to-beat monitoring. You can use it for using the repeated arterial blood gas analysis sampling. You can use your non-invasive cardiac output monitoring with using pulse control analysis with just with the arterial line, and in certain cases can use cardiac output. Now there are many indications for this. In anesthesia, we generally use for all the major surgeries where we expect lots of fluid shifts, the patients where you have got lots of underlying comorbidities, the cardiac cases, the cases where you expect lots of hemodynamic instability like cases with pheochromocytomas or the carotid body tumor surgeries, cases where we want to give the deliberate induced hypotension or where not exactly hypotension but we want to get the blood pressure slightly low. And because in all those cases where you have got a monitoring, the NIBP blood pressure, non-invasive blood pressure monitoring may not be accurate, as in you have got a very obese patient where you may not get a proper sized cuff there, or the patients who have got burns, or the patient who is in shock. So arterial blood pressure monitoring in the perioperative period is used very frequently. In intensive care, it's again one of the major modality of hemodynamic monitoring, where we use it in all critical ill patients, the patients who are in vasopressors, the patients who are in shock, or in the cardiothoracic ICUs where the patients are on intra-aortic balloon counterpulsation, where your arterial pressure monitoring is must. So in short, we use arterial pressure monitoring very frequently and routinely in the ICUs. So let's look at what are the various sites where we can use the arterial pressure monitoring. In the upper limb, we have got radial artery, we have got brachial artery, we have got axillary artery. In the lower limb, we have got dorsalis pedis artery, we have got posterior tibial artery, and we have got femoral artery. Now each artery, puncturing each artery for monitoring purpose has got pros and cons. So whenever we're using any invasive technique, there are two things that we look at. What is the success rate or the ease of using that particular site? And what is the complication rate or the problems that I can face if I use that particular site? Now, if you look at this, the brachial artery is now the first and foremost is the safety. Like when I'm using arterial cannulation, whenever I'm using artery for a continuous monitoring by putting a catheter inside it, I'm obviously going to decrease or block the flow through that artery. Now, the moment I decrease the flow through that artery, I have to be sure that the portion which is supplied, the distal portion which is supplied by that artery for the blood flow, should not suffer from the anoxia. That means there has to be a good collateral circulation in case if this artery develops any complication. So first and foremost is that safety. So when we look at the arteries, especially the brachial artery does not have any collateral circulation, and that's why it is not a favorite.